everyone, and happy Easter. I am starting a new series called National Days. Every day has a holiday, like for example, today is Easter, but did you know that today is also National Librarian Day? So basically, I am going to be reading some stories dedicated to the special events for today. Our first story will be about Easter. This story is called The Adventurous Bunny and Easter Island, and it is by Mike Gralish. Any number of years ago, a boat put to sea. On board was a small bunny with big ears. When her last adventure in the garden took a bad turn, she was captured and sentenced to stew. One night, some little hands slipped below deck. They placed the bunny in a basket and took her from the belly of the boat. Her big ears were free once more to seek fun and adventure. And fun and adventure she found. She spent many joyous seasons with the little hands around the rigging, sharing the wonder of the whole wide world. They were very happy and grew very strong. But just as summer turns to fall, our bunny is about to find herself over her head in another adventure. It was night on the high sea. Big ears and little hands were gently rockabye rocking. Then everything changed. Fingers of lightning pulled angry clouds over the ocean. Monster waves stomped the sea. The big boat was tossed around like a baby in the bathtub. As the boat strained to starboard, the bunny was plucked to port. Big ears bobbed in the stormy sea with only a basket for company. Things like that happen in adventures. By the time the calming colors chased away the clouds, this adventure was getting too wet for a bunny in a basket. Thank goodness she was joined by a couple of flat-eared friends. They skipped her across the sea to the land of forever green, Easter Island. This spring oasis was the perfect home for our adventurous bunny. It is full of life, love, and Easter magic. And what is Easter magic? It's the sweetest kind. For example, on Easter Island, tasty dewdrops kiss the morning leaves. Hummingbirds skittle from flower to flower. Jelly bean pods open at the slightest touch. And chocolate fruits hop in the breeze. The magic of Easter Island does not stop at land's end. Surrounding this island is a reef that's peep-pled with colorful coral, spectacular sponges, and crafty creatures. But the pride of the island are the popcorn trees. Once a year, when the first full moon shines on the spring equinox, the popcorn trees make their fruit. The fruit of the popcorn trees is eggs, red and yellow and pink and green, purple and orange and blue. A rainbow of flavor for your eyes cover hill and dale. The big-eared bunny was very happy in her new home. One full moon night in the heart of spring, in soft Easter grass with a fiddler crab song, a cozy mind mists to memories. She remembers the wave and wake of small adventurers moved on. She remembers the joy and love that these little hands bring to life, rekindling us all with their smiles and possibilities. She remembered the whole world over, how the earth is reborn with each spring and mankind is reborn with each little hand. The next morning sun hatched a grand plan. She would share the sweet spring harvest of Easter Island with all the children of the world. With the help of her furry feathered and soft-scaled friends, a great harvest began. The sea sparkled with activity as excitement grew. At week's end, the greatest fleet the world had ever seen set sail from Easter Island. The Easter Bunny skippered basket and crew to all points of wind to share the joy and fruitful harvest that comes from rebirth with little hands like yours. Happy Easter!
Happy School Librarian Day! Now that we are done with the topic of Easter, let's talk about school librarians. You may not know a lot of school librarians, but here is a really famous one. This is Carol Coulthau. Carol Collier Coulthau is a professor emerita of Library and Information Science at Rutgers University, where she directed the graduate program in school librarianship that has been rated number one in the country by US News. She achieved the rank of Distinguished Professor, a special rank at Rutgers requiring additional review beyond that for full professor. She also chaired the Department of Library and Information Science and was the founding director of the Center for International Scholarship and School Libraries, which is CISSL. She is internationally known for her groundbreaking research on the information search process and for the ISP model of affective, cognitive, and physical aspects in six stages of information seeking and use. She has authored Seeking Meaning, a Process Approach to Library and Information Services, and Teaching the Library Research Process, and published widely in referred journals and edited volumes. Two new books, Guided Inquiry, Learning in the 21st Century, and Guided Inquiry Design, a Framework for Inquiry in Your School, authored with her daughters, Leslie K. Manioz and Anne K. Caspery, are now available through Libraries Unlimited. Happy Vitamin C Day! National Vitamin C Day on April 4th each year shares all the ways vitamin C nurtures and benefits our health inside and out. While vitamin C is widely recognized for warding off colds, the vitamin is also clinically proven to be a powerhouse in other areas of health too. For example, vitamin C may reduce blood pressure and potentially lower the risk of heart disease. Those at risk of gout can lower that risk by increasing their intake of vitamin C. Topically, vitamin C keeps skin healthy by protecting it from oxidative damage caused by daily exposure to light, heat, and pollution. The popularity of topical vitamin C products has risen dramatically. With the right product, adding vitamin C to your beauty regimen can brighten your skin, reduce inflammation, and produce healthy collagen production. Vitamin C brightens just about any health routine. Happy National Walk Around Things Day! This day may be looked at both figuratively and literally. Literally, one would not walk through a puddle of water or mud. One would walk around it. One would not walk under a ladder or over broken glass. One would walk around both. Figuratively, one would walk around, avoiding certain problems or potential problems. One would also walk around, avoiding arguments, certain situations, or unwanted or uncomfortable conversations. Another possible intent of this day could very well be to walk around things such as a neighborhood park or the shopping mall. While we're walking around, we might also walk around obstacles or structures we come across during our stroll. In a park, we might find a fountain or a swing set to walk around. At the mall, benches or planters interrupt our easy stride. Of course, at home, we have all sorts of things that we walk around willingly. Sometimes the reason we walk around these items is pure avoidance, like laundry or clutter. We might also walk around a sleeping pet. Happy Jeep 4X4 Day! On 4/4, like this one over here, like April 4th, Jeep 4X4 Day launches us into adventure. Celebrate the excitement of discovery while venturing out in the open air. Fresh air and warmer temperatures lure us outdoors, and what better way to experience the thrill of an excursion than in a Jeep 4X4? Whether it's up a rocky slopes or through muddy trails, Jeep vehicles let you take adventure to a whole new level. Crossing creeks, touring valleys, and maneuvering through rocky terrain are just part of the trek. In a Jeep brand vehicle, you can see lost history and beautiful vistas. Get away with friends for the day or take off a week by yourself to refuel. This celebration reminds us that every day was meant for adventure. Happy National Hug a Newsperson Day! National Hug a Newsperson Day, formerly National Hug a Newsman Day, on April 4th encourages appreciation for the people reporting the news. The Merriam-Webster Dictionary tells us that the word newsman dates back to 1596. They have been working hard for many years to bring us the news from around the world. A few well-known newspersons include Tom Brokaw, Barbara Walters, David Brinkley, Katie Couric, Walter Cronkite, Anne Curry, Lester Holt, Peter Jennings, and Connie Chung. Your local newsperson reports on the day's events in your community. They keep you informed of important political news, businesses in your community, weather, traffic, crime, and education updates. When it comes to the national news, the local news reporters apply local perspectives. While events may happen thousands of miles away, a local newsperson knows it impacts their views still. On the national and world scale, a newsperson may travel far and wide for the complete story. Some are attached to certain regions of the world, specializing in political, economic, or health news. Wherever they report from, they bring the news into our homes, cars, businesses, or wherever we may be. They keep us informed of the ever-changing world around us. Happy Geologist Day! From the Earth's crust to deep into its core, we recognize Geologist Day on the first Sunday in April. Geologists study the history, structure, and impact of other processes on the Earth. Their discoveries and research play an essential role in our daily lives. Geology blends well with other sciences, such as chemistry and physics. In fact, they are necessary for agriculture, architecture, and weather prediction. Those who pursue a geology degree open up a wide range of careers. From oceanography to NASA, education, government, and research, geology offers a worldview to applicants. Hobbyists and enthusiasts have a place in geology too. Even amateur geologists contribute to the science from time to time. That is part of the intrigue of geology and why we celebrate the day. Happy Chicken Cordon Bleu Day! Each year on April 4th, National Chicken Cordon Bleu Day celebrates a blue ribbon dish that combines chicken, ham, and cheese. The French term cordon bleu translates to blue ribbon. This dish is a take on the popular veal cordon bleu. It is a flattened chicken breast, which is wrapped around ham or sometimes prosciutto or Canadian bacon, and cheese such as Swiss or Gruyère. Toothpicks hold the chicken together before being dipped in an egg wash and breaded. The earliest recipe we were able to find was in a March 1964 printing of the Cincinnati Enquirer by the Cincinnati gourmet Stanley Desmos. Despite some misconceptions, it is an American dish. Desmos mentions in his column that he got the idea to try chicken instead of veal to be different. It has been a popular dish since. Okay everyone, that's it for the video. Thank you for watching and I hope you have a good day.